sige, punta tayo dito sa maximum minimum. So, ito yung last na application ng differential calculus. So, sobrang ganda ng maximum minimum. So, sa maximum minimum, meron tayong dalawang approach. Depende sa scenario. No? So, yung unang approach is yung ito. Yung general approach. So, sa general approach, kung gusto natin, kung meron siyang, for example, yung variable natin na A is to be maximized or minimized. So, yung ginagawa lang is, dinidifferentiate lang natin yung A, then, ini-equate natin to 0. So, ganun, ganun lang. So, derivative ng A equals 0. Provided na yung A is to be maximized or to be minimized. So, depende yan. Maximize ba o minimize, equate mo yan lahat to 0. So, yan yung sa general approach. So, pag sinabi natin general approach, so, ibig sabihin lahat ng problem related to maxima and minima, ito lang yung solution. Okay? So, general siya. Then, we have also this special approach, which is applicable lang for this case. Kaya, meron tayong special approach. So, applicable lang siya sa case na ito. Meron na yung case 1, case 2, case 3, and case 4. So, anyway, yung concept lang nila lahat is the same. Equality rule. So, ayan, no? Pag yung sum and perimeter is constant, then yung product or area is to be maximized. So, pwedeng gamitin yung equality rule. No? Pag sinabi natin equality rule, lahat ng variable equal. So, x equals y equals z. All variables are the same. So, ito lang yung rule natin. So, napakaganda din yung technique na to kasi nami-minimize na yung solution. At saka nama-maximize mo yung time mo. Okay? So, another case is if yung sum and perimeter is to be minimized while yung product and area is constant or given. So, pag sinabing constant, that is given. Constant or given. So, yun pa rin yung gagamitin. X equals Y equals Z. Then, we have also the regular polygon. So, parang X equals Y equals Z pa rin yan eh. So, maximum yung area for a given perimeter, di ba? Or minimum yung perimeter for a given area. So, same lang. Yeah? Maximum yung area for a given perimeter. Or minimum yung perimeter for a given area. So constant area given. Sa regular polyhedron naman is same lang, naging volume lang, tsaka total surface area. So, maximum yung volume given yung total surface area or minimum yung total surface area for a given volume. So, yun yung sa regular polyhedron. Then, we have also the circle. So, pag nililimit lang yung perimeter natin, so yun, no? Bali, smallest possible perimeter na makakuha ka ng maximum area. So, walang iba. Si circle. Kaya napaka-economical nung circle kung gagamitin na yan sa design ng tunnel. Kaso, ang hirap i-perfect nung circle sa construction. Anyway, yung concept niya is yung circle is maximum yung area for smallest possible perimeter. Okay, so yun lang yung maxima and minima. So, solve din ang problem. Okay, so divide daw natin yung 90 into 3 parts so that their product is maximum. So, meron tayong sulit na lang natin na yung x, y, and z be the numbers. So, tatlo yan, no? The first part, second part, and the third part. Kasi sabi niya, yung 90 dinivide natin into 3 parts. So, ito na yung 3 parts, x, y, and z. So, ibig sabihin, yung x plus y plus z is just equal to 90. Diba? And then, yung yan yung sum. And then, yung product is x, y, and z is to be maximized. Ayan. So, since may kita mo na yung sum is given for a maximum product, so under yan yung equality rule. So, ibig sabihin, so, by equality rule, yung x is just equal to y is just equal to z. So, masolve na natin yung problem. So, meron tayong x, 90. Or 3x equals 90. Or x is just 30. So, ganun din yung y. 30. Ganun din yung z. 30. Okay? So, ito na yung sagot. Okay? So, I hope klaro yan for equality rule. So, titignan mo lang yung problem kung na-under siya sa equality rule. Kasi kung isosolve mo yan ng general equation, general approach, sobrang haba. Parang ayaw mong tapusin, no? So, kaya yung maganda is i-check mo muna kung under na siya ng equality rule para mas mabilis yung computation mo. Another problem, ito, a triangle has a variable sides of x, y, and z subject to the constraint such that the perimeter is fixed to 18 cm. So, what is the maximum possible area for the triangle? So, may kikita mo na under pa rin siya sa equality rule. So, bali dito yung meron tayong triangle. So, yung perimeter niya is fixed to 18. So, ibig sabihin, yung sum ay yung perimeter is given. So, perimeter. And then, yung area, yeah, so, since given yung side niya, so, Heron's formula yung gagamitin ko. So, S minus X, S minus Y, and S minus Z. So, maximum possible area. So, this is to be maximized. And then, ito is given. Okay? So, kung titignan mo yan, pag yung perimeter is given for a maximum area, under yan ang equality rule. So, by equality rule, yung x lang is just equal to y is just equal to z. Okay? Or yung s natin, computing ko muna yung value no, sa isang side. So, x plus y plus z equals 18. So, therefore, we have x plus x plus x, 18. So, 3x equals 18. So, x is just equal to 6. See ya. So, since x equals y equals z, so therefore, lahat yan, 6 yan. So, yung half nung perimeter natin, meron tayong x plus y plus z, or that is just one half nung 18. Huh? So, we have 9cm. So, by Heron's formula, so, masolve na natin yung maximum possible na area. So, s times a, s minus x times s minus y and s minus z. So, we have now square root ng 9. 9 minus 6. 9 minus 6. And 9 minus 6. So, therefore, yung area natin is just equal to and yan. Now, we have square root sa 9 times 9 minus 6 times 9 minus 6 times 9 minus 6. 15.59. So, we have 15.59 square centimeter. So, buksan natin yan kasi yan na yung sagot. Okay? So, I hope klaro yan. Another problem is find the area of the largest radian that a 10-meter string could enclose. So, makikita mo dito na limitado yung perimeter natin. Okay? So, limitado. So, ibig sabihin, yung perimeter natin is limited to 10 meter. Okay? Wala nang iba. Wala tayong pwedeng magamit. So, ibig sabihin, ano yung gagawin natin sa 10 meter na string? Ito yung 10 meter na string. So, ano yung gagawin natin dyan, no? Para makakuha tayo ng maximum area. So, under yan dito, no? No? Yung sa circle. Kung smallest or limited lang yung perimeter mo, yung makakuha ka ng maximum area, dapat circle yung gamitin mo. So, i-circle lang natin yan. So, may natin ganyan. So, since same lang, ito lang din yan eh. Ito ng material lang din yan eh. So, ibig sabihin, yung circumference nito is also 10 meter. And alam natin yung circumference ng circle is 2 pi r. Di ba? So, therefore, yung r natin is 10 all over 2 pi. No? Or that is 5 over pi. So, yung tanong niya, ano daw yung area? So, area is just pi r squared. So, thus, we have pi nung 5 pi squared. So, therefore, we have 25 all over pi square meter. So, baksan natin yan kasi yan na yung sagot. Okay. So, I hope klaro tayo dyan. I hope klaro tayo dyan. So, another problem. So, the age of a wooden box used in shaping electronics items are to be reinforced by metal strip to be nailed on all the edges. So, if the box is to have a volume of 8 cubic meter, so find its dimension in order to utilize minimum amount of metal strip. So meron daw tayo ditong box. Ayan, no? So, bali yung volume nito is 8 cubic meter. So, yung kailangan natin is ma-minimize natin yung amount ng metal strip. And yung metal strip, alam mo yun, na to be nailed in all the edges. So, yun. So, inail daw natin lahat ng metal strip na yan. So, ibig sabihin, yung surface area yan. So, bali yung total surface area natin is to be minimized. No? Kasi ito yung strip eh. Yung surface niya, mga strip yan. So, ito yung metal strip. Then, dito, metal strip yan. Nailed out natin yan. Ito, metal strip din to. Nailed out natin yan. And so on and so forth. No? So, lahat ng surface area is to be minimized. So, pag yung volume is given, diba? Ito, volume. This is given. And then, yung total surface area is to be minimized. So, applicable yung equality rule. So, by equality rule, yung if I assume x, y, and z, and so x equals y equals z. Or, let's say that is a cubical box. So, yung wooden box na yan, cube yan. Okay, so, masolve na natin yung problem. So, yung volume nung box is x, y, and z, and that is just equal to 8. So, by equality rule, yung x equals y equals z, so meron tayong x, x, and x, 8, so x cube, 8, so x is equals to 2. So, thus, yung tanong niya, ano daw yung dimension? So, thus, the dimension of the box is 2 meter by 2 meter by 2 meter. So, buksan natin yan kasi yan na yung sagot. Okay, so far for equality rule ng maximum and minimum. Sige, so see you in the next video. Thank you.